Hey guys, welcome back for another Slash My Stash. I feel like I should have like a cool like sword slicing montage. Ching ching! Like on that ninja game where you slice through the fruit. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Okay, so we are going to be doing the second half of my Sally Hansen Helmer today. So this is everything that wasn't in the last one. That was all comprised of the extreme wear and the complete salon manicure pretty much, and a little bit of the argan oil formula ones. So in this one you will find all my Insta-dries, even some luster shines. You guys remember these from a couple years ago? The sugar shimmers from a couple years ago too. So you guys, we're gonna go ahead and get to it. As you know, if you've been here with me on these Slash My Stash, basically I'm just trying to de-stash and not hoard so much polish. So I'm gonna be quickly going through things, making split decisions right when I'm filming the voiceover of the edit through all the polishes. And I will just decide to let some polishes go and hopefully make happy homes. These will be listed very affordably on my store and V site. I list everything for at least half of what I purchased them for. And, you know, in the hopes to send them to homes who will wear them, use them, think about them more frequently than I do, and to hopefully get some polishes to those of you who, you know, maybe you're on a low buy or something right now, and so you want to buy, you know, prices that are slashed. Before I make too much more of a fool of myself, like I always do on my channel, let's go ahead and get into this de-stash. So we're gonna get started with an older polish in my collection. Do you guys remember the Luster Shine polishes? These were some of the original like duochromes that you would see somewhere around. They weren't like that impressive. I think I'm gonna hold on to a couple of them. That first one, Lava, is not gonna be one that I will hold on to. This is a white from the Hard as Nails line. I think this might be the only thing I've held on to from this line. It's an okay white. I don't think I'll hang on to that one though, because I have other ones that I like better. Okay, so I have a bunch from the Sugar Coat that I held on to as well. See, a lot of older polishes is going to be in this video, you guys. These textured polishes are really pretty. I don't ever think to use them. I might hold on to one or two, but I'm not going to hold on to that one. Emerald Express, we're also going to be looking at all these Insta-dries. I have two polishes that are exactly the same, I feel like. I will keep one, so either this one or the other one that I will show you guys in just a minute. The Velvet Textures, Sally Hansen used to try a lot of different things. This one is one of the prettiest, I feel like, out of that line, the velvet textured polishes, so I'm going to hang on to Lush. I think that's so gorgeous. These Sally Hansen Salon nail lacquers in these rectangle bottles are basically the oldest polishes in my collection. They are great classics. I mean, look at that. I'm gonna hang on to it. I love it. It's nostalgic for me. Mint Tint. This is one of the more fun sugar shimmers, I feel like. But again, I just don't really think of wearing it. Oh, that's so cute though. I'm undecided on that one. Sorry. Plummet, this is a really great, very dark purple with a great formula. That was pretty much a one coater. Oh my goodness. That one's hard for me to decide from as well. Oh, I think I'm gonna list Plummet. I'm definitely gonna list this glitter. It is one of the most interesting glitters that I kept from them, but I just never think to wear it. Spare a Mint, another Sugar Coat. This is another green one, and it is very pretty. Let me see what it looks like on. It is really, really pretty. I just don't ever think to wear them. This is the other one that was very similar to that first emerald one. I think I'm gonna keep the emerald one and go ahead and let go of Jet Set Jade. Look, they're very, very similar. Both super duper gorgeous. This air polish from the Smooth and Perfect is also one of the older polishes in my collection. Really beautiful, very, very light blue, but I never ever think about it, so I'm actually gonna let this one go. I held on to one French manicure polish. I do have a few now from Zoya, so I'm gonna go ahead and let this one
go as well. I rarely ever think to wear like a French manicure look, but it's a good idea to hang on to a polish like that in case you want to. Here's another one of these Luster Shine Multichrome. It's not really multichrome, maybe a duochrome. This one is one of the prettier ones. No, I think I will probably pass that one along. I think I'm just going to hang on to one. This Sugar Coat I really did think is beautiful. It's quite striking. Let's see what it looks like on. I think I'm going to end up destashing most of the texture polishes today. Yeah, I think I'm going to destash that. That is so striking though. That's really, really beautiful. Firefly, another duochrome polish. I am impressed that they did duochrome, but what was this, 6 years ago? And they really haven't done anything like that. I'm going to pass that one along. Denim, as we discussed in a recent Crayola video, they have two blues that are exactly the same. I'm going to hang on to this one and destash the other one as it comes up in just a little bit. That is a great, basically, one coat blue. Apricot, this is a fun color. I don't think you're going to see anything else swatched like this from Sally Hansen today. Let me see, I can't remember. This one was it kind of patchy at two coats? I mean, it looks okay. I think I'm going to hang on to that. That's a really interesting color from them. This is another one of my OGs. Even though it's OG, I've probably only worn these OGs one or two times. But these are like the only colors that they even used to make ever, it feels like. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm going to part with that one. This is Deep End Triple Shine. This may be the only triple shine you see today because it's really the only one I hung on to. I didn't really like most of the others that I tried from this line. I'm going to go ahead and pass that one along as well. Orange Zest. I have three oranges that are almost all identical. This will be one that I'm passing along, and there's going to be another that I list on my destash as well. It's so pretty, but I don't need three of the exact same polish from the exact same brand. Another velvet texture that I held on to. This is Lavish. It is very, very beautiful. I don't love it quite as much as Lush though, so in comparison, I think I will pass that one along because I never think about wearing it. Copperhead. This is pretty. This one's a little bit more interesting. It's kind of like a purple to orange almost, except the shift isn't that dramatic. I'm going to pass that one along. Another Sugar Shimmer. I will probably be passing this one along, putting it on my destash. Let me just see how it looks on though. That's really fun. It does have a beautiful gold shimmer, but I will go ahead and list that. Pink Platinum is the only color foil that I held onto. This is really beautiful, beautiful chrome pink. Look at that, that's stunning. I don't know. I might hold on to that one still. You guys know I love gold. This one has great coverage. I'm gonna hang on to that one as well. That's just outstanding coverage, and that's a really good go-to when you just need to slap on a quick gold and go. Taffeta, now we're looking at some satin glam polishes. That's really pretty. I love these matte ones. I think I'm gonna pass that one along though, but the matte ones are so great. No S pair time. I'm gonna hold on to that polish as well. Just look at that. That is just my kind of jam right there. Plume, this is the one I decided to keep. I feel like just looking around the bottle, you can actually see three colors. This one's probably the best shifty pigment, so this is the one I'm gonna hold on to. There's just so many multichromes out there. I don't ever really think of wearing these originals, but it is nice to have one or two. Sugar Plum, I'm gonna list that. Sorry, didn't talk about that for long, but it's pink, so I never really think about it. Berry Sweet, it's from that Salon Nail Lacquer line. This is an older polish in my collection, probably been swatched once, and this is the second time right here. And it's just not something I think to wear. Azure, another of the Luster Shines. This one needs a little bit more coatage, it looks like, but it's still very beautiful. I'm going to list that one. That one's kind of like a indigo to blue shift. Quick Genius. This is beautiful, metallic, little tiny metallic flecks in there, but I think I'm going to list that one as well. So Much Fawn. Here's another polish from that OG Sally Hansen. Kind of vintage by now almost. It's like polishes only came in the 5 colors, and I have all the colors that they used to release polish in. I'm going to go ahead and list that one. Work of Tarte. This is a blue with a gold shimmer. And again, I will probably list this. Yep. I just don't think about it. Beautiful. This is the polish that's exactly like denim that I was telling you guys about. They're both from Crayola Collections, and I do not need both. They're both stunning, but I don't need both, so I'll list this one. Teal Tulle from the Satin Glam. Oh, this is so beautiful. I'm going to keep this one. Keep. Ah, love that. Gorgeous finish. I Rush Luck. This one is so pretty, you guys. Goodness sakes. I think I'm going to list that. It is so stunning, but I'm going to go ahead and list it. Canary, this is a very light white yellow, and you probably need 3 coats. I'm going to hold on to this, though, because like Apricot, it's a really different kind of polish than I have from anything else I'm swatching today. Gummy Grape, again from the Sugar Shimmer. I have destashed every single one. Let me see how I feel about this one after we're done here. That's probably one of the more interesting to me, but I think I'm still going to destash it. Quick Fire. I have a lot of reds that we're going to be looking at coming up here. I don't really know that I necessarily need to keep any of them. Oh, that's a beautiful jelly red, though. I think I'll still list it. I don't know that I'm going to keep any of them because there's so many reds in the world and they're just creams. So Peach Buzz, that has some gorgeous pink shimmer. I think I'm still going to list it anyway, though. Scarlet, gorgeous red. This might be the one I keep. Like, I should just keep at least one, right, from the Crayola collection. They release so many. So I'll keep just one. I think it's going to be this one. That's just a really great classic red. Buried Under. Oh, this one's so pretty. Let me see. Maybe this is the one I'm going to keep. It's really, really pretty. It's like a very light. I'm going to keep that one. Yep. I decided that'll be the one Sugar Shimmer I keep. Gilt, kind of like a tawny to golden green shift there. I'll go ahead and list this one. Wild Strawberry, one of the 100 reds we're going to look at. I will list this. Look at that. That's stunning, though. Perfect at one coat. So easy. They really did a good job with their one coat creams here. Cerulean. That's really gorgeous too. I think I'll list that one though. I feel like I kept a lot of blues on the last Sally Hansen video. Navy Fleet, this is a really beautiful kind of greeny, dark navy. Oh, that's so pretty. I'm gonna list it though. Sunsheen from the Satin Glam. I feel like I loved this polish and we didn't look a lot of oranges today. Yeah, I'm going to keep that one. I'm going to keep it. It's pretty different than everything else. Vivid Violet. Gorgeous. One coat. So easy. I will pass this one along, though. I'm going to list it. I just have way too many purples. Carnation Pink. This one will be listed because I don't like pink. I think that I just held on to all these Crayolas, anticipating this video coming up. But that is perfection. That's a perfect pink if you like pink. Dandelion, I will be holding on to because I do love yellows. This one is a really good one. It wasn't like my ideal perfect yellow, but it was pretty close. It was great. Rags to Riches. Rags to Riches from the Lasting Finish Pro. I'll go ahead and list that. That looks like the only one we swatched from that. Oh, that's a Rimmel. What the heck, Rimmel? Sorry, guys. That was a little confusing. Surprise! Oh, that's pretty. I'm going to hold on to that. Okay, so that Rimmel made a little sneak appearance in this video. Razzmatazz, that's also really gorgeous. Did you guys pick up these one coat Crayola Sally Hansen's? They're incredible. I will probably list Razzmatazz. Ablazing is really pretty. It has some very fine gold shimmer. Shoot, maybe I want to keep that one instead of Scarlet. I'm going to keep that or Scarlet. Purple Heart, also stunning formula. So, so easy. I'm going to go ahead and list it still, though. We are actually almost done, guys. Razzle Dazzle Rose, I will list this. It is pink. I know somebody else will love it so much more than I. All these Crayola ones ended up being at the end of my swatching, I think. This is so good. I'm gonna hold on to this one. This was pretty similar to Eye Rush Luck. That one was darker though. I'm gonna hold on to this one. That is just amazing. That green is so good. The Deepest of Violets. I think this is the final one from that OG line that I held on to. This color speaks to me so much. I'm gonna hold on to that. That's where my sentimentality comes in. I have to hold on to at least one or two from that very oldest line. Okay, these two oranges are right next to each other. I will pick one to keep and one to destash. Sunset Orange or Atomic Tangerine. Yeah, I don't need both. They were exactly the same. Look, you can even see them right there. I'll probably keep Sunset Orange, I think. Whichever one was first released, I'll keep that one. Maroc Go. This is such a strange color compared to all the rest of the things we've looked at today. I'm going to hold on to it. That is such a just off the wall kind of shade for today. Wisteria, I'm going to hold on to. It is so pale. It's so much white in there. Gorgeous, gorgeous shade. I'm going to hold on to that one. Only two left. Wild Watermelon will be destashed. It is stunning, but not the kind of shade that I like to wear. But ooh, that is pretty. So, so pretty. And then very last, Inchworm, one of my favorite Sally Hansen's that I acquired this year. If you don't have this polish, please go pick it up. It's so cool. Such great coverage. Look at that. That's fantastic. So I'm going to keep that. All right, guys. So here's the progress that I made today. Everything on the left is what I'm going to destash, and on the right, that is what I'm going to hang on to. It really does me good to see it, you know, just displayed this way after I'm all finished, so that I can see that I am getting rid of more things on the left than I am keeping, because I don't want to just hold on to things for collecting's sake. Now that my collection is so large, more large than it's easy for me to maintain, I want to make sure that I'm only keeping the things that I'm actually thinking about wearing and that actually truly appeal to me. So, like I said, everything on the left will be going up on my destash site. We have one more destash video coming up. That is the last part of that Indy Helmer. And then all of the polishes that I destashed from those four videos will be going up on that Store Envy site, where you can shop from the multiple brands at the same time if you would like to. And hopefully they will go to homes where people will want to wear them and they won't just be sitting on shelves like they've been doing at my house. So, anyway, you guys, thanks for coming by for this video today. I hope that you really enjoyed it. It's really actually kind of therapeutic for me to kind of like take one last dance around the room with polishes that I've purchased and then say so long. So anyway, you guys, again, thanks for joining me. I will see you back for the next video very soon. Have a super rest of your day, and I will see you back again later. Bye-bye.